I think she was one of the guys who made me to be married to my then boyfriend.
Zinu zenya ne kuarara zina kurongeka. Mneta zinzina mukuita na sekuarara zinu zenya zina kurongeka. Ende utanga kuti langae langane rafu langano shauta langano shauta. Ina ndiri zana zina kurongeka zinu zenya zina kurongeka ina ndiri skusida.
SAYWHAT has been implementing a project branded the One Campus Project in three provinces in Zimbabwe, which is Bulawayo Metropolitan Province, Midlands Province, and Matabeleland South.
James chapter 1, verse 17. Every good and perfect gift is from the above, coming down from the Father of the heavenly lights, who does not change like shifting shadows. True to this scripture, on the 15th of May 1985, a sexual and reproductive health advocate and champion, Langalethu Nkala, was born in the city of Kings and Queens, Bulawayo.
And it's the same thing with I'm a PA educator, or rather the teacher. For you to be able to teach, you should be having a class. And you to have the class, for you guys, it's kind of different because you don't mobilize. I'm under a bar, so you're corner, you just can teach and do everything else. But if it's really you doing something that is outside your normal sphere of work, which is teaching.
A beautiful and enthusiastic figure who was ready to explore and release her potential to the maximum to the ever-awaiting world. Langa started her academic journey at John Taylor School, where her dream was shaped and cultivated. With flying colors all the way from primary and high school, nothing would stop her from pursuing a diploma at Esgodini Agricultural College. An agriculturalist, cum sexual reproductive health advocate and champion is tongue-in-cheek, but interesting.
My encounter with the Langa was around 2005 at Esgodini College of Agriculture. SAYWHAT started around December 2003. So initially, the focus for SAYWHAT was like in the agriculture colleges.
So I saw a group of young people, of students at Esgodini, and Langalethu was part of them. And one of the tasks that I was given was to elect a local coordinating committee at the very basic. So Langalethu was very outspoken, very interesting, very vocal. And when it was time to elect the local coordinating committee, she was tops, chairperson of the committee.
So on that, I convinced her. Now what I was left with was the issue of accommodation. I had to approach Pamela, my housemate, that there is this issue that is at hand. Pamela, she had known me, the passion that I have for SAYWHAT, and she accepted to allow Langa to come and stay with us, and we stayed together with Langa.
God calls us to a far stable basis for significance. He wants us to establish our identity in the fact that we are His children, created by Him to carry out good works as responsible people in His kingdom. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10.
And Langa implemented a lot of projects. We will always remember her for doing very well in implementing a disability project that she worked with colleges such as the United College of Education in Bulawayo, where she was also able to help the college set up a disability center.
When Langa completed her studies at Esgodini College of Agriculture, where she was pursuing a diploma in agriculture, that phase coincided with the period that we were looking for somebody to assist in terms of our programming. At the same time, I had picked something around her determination.
Langa also played a key role in ensuring that the young women that are within the institutions of higher learning are well organized and mobilized through the Work for Life network. She did very well in the provinces that she was actually leading.
From the day she joined SAYWHAT as a peer educator, Langa's dream to see a healthy generation of young people in Zimbabwe and the SADC region saw her strengthening her understanding of development work by pursuing and successfully completing a Bachelor of Science Honours degree in Development Studies at the Midland State University.
If you speak to the students that she had worked with and mentored, it was Langa who identified Praise. Praise God.
She identified me in the year 2015 when I was still a PhD at Midland State University. To me, I had just met a fellow Ndebele speaking sister. Little did I know that I had met someone who was going to nurture and groom me to become a fully fledged programmer that I am today.
Well, I met Langa in 2016. I was still a GT, a graduate intern. And she was one of the very first people who gave me a chance.
I started knowing Langa 2018. We met at National Youth Conference. That's when we first met. She used to be very vibrant when I was Zoom meeting. So when we met in 2018, I was very much anticipating meeting her.
She had this unique ability to understand the personal needs of people, and should accommodate them all. And no one else would ever know that this person is sharing her secrets with Langa, and I am sharing my secrets with Langa. She was a friend of everyone.
When I joined SAYWHAT, she did a lot in terms of boosting my confidence, in terms of also helping me settling in a team. You join a group, very switched on.
Sowing seeds of dynamism and versatility characterizing SAYWHAT's story, and even more a testimony to its growth, was Langa's identity. Like everyone else, Langa had a social life, and different from the rest, she was an ever-smiling character.
Langa was a very jovial person. I used to drink a lot. When I traveled here, she didn't drink, and I used to drink. But I convinced her for us to go out, look for a place where I can drink. And she would, sit by my side, talking, laughing, as if she drank.
She asked me to choose anything that I wanted from the store, just to celebrate my birthday. She bought the biggest cake in the store. I remember we started singing in the store. We sang, and attracted a lot of attention.
He intimately called me Dodo when I was still single, and later on she always find ways really to call me names. When I got married, my husband's name was Chikorova, but she would try really to change it and say Chikorobo.
Zinu zenyane kuarara zina kurongeka. Mneta zinzina, mukuita zina se kuarara zinu zenyane zina kurongeka. Ende utanga kuti langaye, langane, rafu, langano, shauta, langano, shauta. Ina andiri zana zina kurongeka, zinu zenyane zina kurongeka, ina andis kusida. And then you'll be stopped at a police roadblock. Then the first thing she would say like, Officer, And when she starts saying that, you know, something is wrong for motorbike.
Tashika, we then told it that we're trying to find the best thing to give you, because she was very particular. She didn't eat grapes from the streets. She was particular.
As fate would have it, God had other plans for Langa, just like he had for everyone else in this room. On the 19th of September, 2021, a dark cloud engulfed the SAYWHAT family. Langa passed on.
I met Langa 2 years ago in 2019. I was a first year student, very fresh into varsity, and when my friends introduced me to the Peer Educators Club, they also encouraged me to apply for a position that was there for Resource Center Minder.
Ngibelethuba elihle kakhulu sisebenza lo Langa le SAYWHAT. Bekulula kanjani ukuthi sim-approach uLanga nxa silama programs ethu awe wellness yama students ube ngumuntu approachable abantwana bekulula ukuthi baye kulanga bebamfonele bathi sisilanga sifuna into enje.
The following day, very early in the morning, the brother called me. And then she was like, "Hi, Nono, how are you?" And say, unfortunately, your friend has passed on. I was shocked because I had spoken to Langa. She was well. She was happy. She was like the normal Langa we had known. And then I was just told that she has passed on.
It was unfortunate that by the time I was texting this message, Langa had gone to be with the Lord. I didn't know. But I was wondering, this was them that she was online. Then I was just, no, Langa, pick up my calls, blah, 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 and all those things. Then the next thing I received a communication from, I received two communications from almost both angles, from the brother and from our HR department.
It was a very difficult moment at that time to really believe it, because at the point of Langa's passing on, she was demonstrating quite a lot of signs of recovery.
The whole office was sad. There was no life at the office. Everything just went to sea. It was hard to wake on that day.
The last conversations that I had with Langa, which were more personal, we were discussing about Sandisa's birthday.
It was very painful for me in the sense that my birthday was on the 18th of September, over a weekend, and Langalethu and other colleagues in Mulawa in Harare here organized two unique presents for me. One, it was a wallet, I actually have it here, where they wrote Sandura on this wallet, and a cage for chickens and rabbits. And then the next day, 2 days, I was told Langa is no more.
I didn't want to have time alone because I knew that if I would leave or if I would go and stand alone, it would hit me so hard. But I couldn't run away from it. After the training, when I went back to my hotel room, I couldn't control myself. I cried and everything started coming to say, so Langa is no longer there. Langa, usisu Langa kaseko.
No matter how many times we lose friends, colleagues, relatives, and workmates, death remains scary and strange. For SAYWHAT, Langa's legacy is more than a consolation.
It's going to be a gap that is going to be very difficult for the institution to fill up.
The legacy of hard work. She was a hard worker. She didn't want things that were not organized. She was a perfectionist. In Shona, she would say, and it is Zunu Snakurungika.
So Langa, to me, she envisioned a SAYWHAT which had great potential in terms of expanding not just its scope but even its reach.
Langalethu Nkala taught me a lot in the trade of youth programming. She taught me how to be patient, she taught me how to be a professional, she taught me how to address young people's needs in a youth-friendly manner. Langalethu Nkala was an individual who paid attention to detail. She was very strict when it comes to work, but her strictness is what made SAYWHAT grow in the field of youth programming.
We used to call her Kiwa because she made sure that, regardless of the fact that she was our boss, we never felt it. Songe as fanana in her eyes, we were all equal, and she treated us with love, care, and it's an aspect that I'll always carry in my life.